Patrice from L'Academie de Cuisine. Salty cod, scary when you hear the word salty, but in fact, very easy to do. A nice specialty from the southern France cooking. The cod, of course, we have cod in the Mediterranean. Cod is available widely everywhere in the world. Very popular fish. Now, would the cod get salty on the boat? So when it gets to you, this is what I have in here. You can see this piece of fish. It looks salty, dry, and you're not quite sure what to do with this. The first thing you want to do is remove all the salt from the cod by putting it in the water. It's going to take you about probably 10 to 12 hours and running in the cold water. You can fill it up in the boat and then keep it in the refrigerator overnight if you have to. But it's very, very important that you remove the salt from the cod, otherwise it will be impossible to eat. Now, I did my homework yesterday and I've got my cod already de-salted or the salt removed out. And you can see what it looks like now. Soft, nice, still a little bit of salt inside, but that's the flavor and that's what we're looking for. Today, what we're going to do is what we call in the south of France, brandade, which is an emulsion of potatoes and cod with olive oil and cream and garlic. It's all good for you. I'm going to grab my pot over here, all right? I'm going to put my thyme, my bay leaf, and the milk. Now, what I like to do also is cut the milk a little bit with water also. This way, it has less tendency to fall in the bottom, the fat from the milk can start burning. So a little bit of cold water in here would be fine. Now, I suggest not to put any salt at that stage because we're not quite sure how far we went down to remove the salt from the cod. So just in case some salt is in there, we're going to salt it later on. That goes on the stove. That's my first step. The second thing I want to do is take my potatoes and also cook it. So I've got Idaho potatoes, just regular baked potatoes. I'm going to grab a pot in here and just put those potatoes in there. Again, no salt. We're not quite sure. So let's make sure we play safe. Some cold water goes in. And I'm going to go and put that on the stove as well. And one thing I'm going to be making sure is both of those things, the cod and the potatoes, are entirely cooked, which means completely soft and almost falling apart. Let me go ahead and take the cod, and to make it easier, it would be much better if we cut the cod in small pieces. You shouldn't have to find any bones in here, but check it out, we never know. So I'm going to cut this in small pieces. You can see here about small dice like this. This way to cook much faster. Okay, this is plenty for me over here. I have probably about a pound of a fish, all right? And I'm gonna go back now and grab the milk and the thyme and the bay leaf and put my fish right into this, all right? And return that to the stove, bring it to a simmer. How long it should take you to cook this? I would say about 5 to 8 minutes. All right, the cream, I have a half a cup. I'm gonna take my cream to a pot. And what I want to do in here is not really bring it to a boil, but right before we start boiling, I'm going to turn it off. Huh? All right, very good. The next thing I want to do is get some, the same amount of cream and olive oil. So I have about half a cup of cream. I'm going to make sure that I have also about half a cup of extra virgin olive oil, which I'm going to bring to a temperature as well, the same temperature than I would do with the cream. So that's about it right here. Let's go ahead and check the cod, see if it's cooked. Let me see that. You're going to grab a piece and see if it falls apart. You can see when I squeeze it between my finger, it all flaky and falls apart. This is a good news. This is ready to go. Potatoes, let me see that. Whoops, same thing in here. You can see they fall apart too. This is perfect. The cream and the olive oil came up to the temperature. I turn it off. Now let's go ahead and do our emulsion. All right, let's take the cod. What I want to do now is I want to drain this cod in here. I'm going to remove the thyme, the bay leaf. I'm going to try to grab just the cod by itself. And I'm going to add it to the machine here. Now, believe me, it's much easier to use an electric mixer to do that. So if you don't have one, you're going to have to borrow one from your friend. But that's really important that you have one. I need to add the garlic also. I could go ahead and put the garlic right now. And I have about 2 tablespoons. This is a garlic dish. So lots of garlic in there. Huh? All right, very good. All right, I'm going to bring the cream and the hot oil and mix it up together here. So here what you do, a little bit of cream, a little bit of oil. And let me show you what it's supposed to look like. It looks fantastic. You can see what's going on in here. Look like mashed potatoes, a little bit thick. This is perfect consistency. This should be good, be careful. You know, the oven is set on broil. You don't want to burn it. That looks very nice. Perfect timing. Let me show you. I'm gonna grab one, it's a little hot in here. But look at that. Nice color. That's exactly what you're looking for. There we go. The right amount of crouton. Perfect. All right. I'm Chef Patrice from L'Académie de Cuisine. This is the way to cook salty cod. Et voilà.